Hey everyone, Eileen Smith here, and in today's video, I want to show you how you can bring photos into your live streams, and we're going to talk about six different ways that that can be done. It's important to think about using photos and graphics during your live stream because it's a way to keep your audience interested as well as engaged. For example, let's say that you're doing product demos. So you want to show off that product from different angles and make sure that your audience gets the chance to see the product in use. Let's say you're doing tutorials. You probably got a ton of screenshots that you want to share. And also, for everyone who wants to have that brand recognition, using your custom graphics during your live stream is another way that you can reinforce that brand. So let's get into it. One of the most common ways to bring a photo into your stream is through a simple screen share. First, you have to open the image. Then you're going to go to the screen sharing setting and you'll choose the window that you want to share, which is the photo. Then once you have that photo in the dashboard, you add it to the stream and you'll see that you can change it to different layouts and different dimensions and sizes. Number two, next we're going to talk about how to do a presentation using Google Slides. You're going to open up your presentation in Google in a different tab. Be sure that you select Screen Share the tab, because this is how your presentation is going to flow really smoothly. You'll be able to navigate through the slides without any of the controls showing up on the screen. Number three, take a look at some other ways you can add photos and branding to your stream right inside the StreamYard dashboard. Look over on the branding tab and you'll see where you can change the colors for the background of your name. Also, you can change the themes. And you can add a logo. So there's the original StreamYard duck logo there, and also overlays. Now for your overlays and for your logos, you want to make sure that you upload a transparent PNG file and the size should be 1920 by 1080. This is number four. Did you ever have a really cool pre-recorded video, or maybe it exists on YouTube or it's over on Facebook, and you want to bring it into your live stream? Well, as long as you have the rights and permissions in order to do that, let me show you how you can share from your web browser and also bring the audio in as well so that your live stream audience can hear that. We're going to choose the share screen option, but this time we're going to make sure we check off the share audio button. That's super important because when you use this option, any music or audio that's playing on the browser will play right through to your live stream. You can mute that audio if you need to. I think this is five. Yeah, it is. It's number five. Upload a background image in your StreamYard dashboard. This is another way that you can promote your brand, but also it gives a nice look and feel when you're using the different layouts, depending upon if you have guests or if you're doing some screen sharing. Last but not least is number six. Another great way to bring in images is by using a virtual camera. Lots of folks who use StreamYard who are also using OBS as their virtual camera. And there's a whole host of other virtual cameras out there. Just drag that image right on screen. So there you go. I can resize it to take up the entire screen if I want. We want you to have a really great experience using StreamYard for your live streams. So if you have any questions, comments, or feedback, go ahead and get in touch with us. Leave it in the comment section below. And we have tons of videos here for you to enjoy. So go ahead and watch another one right now.